All right. Hi, everyone. My name is Emma Storbacka from Avaus, and I'm here today with Scott Brinker, one of the keynote speakers for Martech, the Marketing Technology Summit in Stockholm on the 2nd of February. I'm very pleased to have you here, Scott. You are the thought leader, editor at the chiefmartech.com blog. You are our CTO at Ion Interactive, and everyone at Avaus are at least great fans of yours. So really
thank
happy
you.
To have you.
How are yeah, you doing? Thank you for having me, Emma. It's great to be here with you, and definitely looking forward to the conference here in February.
Fantastic. So I thought I would ask you a couple of questions as kind of a little bit of an interview before the conference. So one of the first ones would be, why would you say that marketing technology is such a hot topic right now?
Yeah, it's a great place to begin. I think the high level answer to that is the world has become digital. You know, everything we do is either directly connected to a digital device or at the very least influenced, supported by digital technologies. And so marketing technology has just become the necessary infrastructure, the necessary capabilities that marketers need to have to engage with their audience in this digital world.
Right. What would you say are the biggest challenges for the marketers then in this new kind of increasingly technology dependent and technology driven world?
There are a lot of challenges. you know, I think, you know, one that it's easy to sort of take for granted, but we shouldn't, is things, a lot has changed very quickly. In a relatively short period of time, the expectations of marketers, the kinds of activities they need to run, the channels they need to manage, the you know, content and services they need to execute. This has just all changed tremendously here over the past few years. And that's challenging to keep up to speed with this, to figure out what it means for your organization, your strategy, the way it you relate to customers. So that's sort of the big challenge. I think we can certainly say within the context of marketing technology, there's a very specific challenge for that, which is the field is remarkably large. There's a tremendous amount of innovation constantly happening in it. And so just even trying to sort out, okay, well, which technologies do what? Which ones should we use? How do we get these things to work well together? That is no small task.
Yeah, and I guess it brings a lot of complexity to an area that previously maybe wasn't so complex. How would you say how to deal with that?
Yeah, you know, for a long time, marketers, what was our software? It was like Excel, Adobe Photoshop, right? You know, we had a very small tool set. It was wonderful. I think Excel still is the number one marketing technology tool. But, you know, so...
Can I quote you on that?
I'm sure Microsoft would definitely appreciate it. So, I mean, but you're right. I mean, now it is an incredibly complex environment. And so there's not an easy answer to this. I mean, the complexity isn't just in the technology, as we were talking about earlier. I mean, the complexity is just out there in the world. There are just so many new ways to engage with customers in a digital world that that is a very complex environment. And so marketing technology, you know, it's in many ways a reaction to that complexity, an attempt to try and help with the complexity, even though sometimes we look at it and we say, well, wow, it might be trying to help with the complexity, but it seems pretty darn complex unto itself. So I guess my first recommendation to people for managing this complexity is to sort of step back and really get some clarity on the principles of who is our audience, what is important to them, how do they want us to reach them? How do they want to reach us? You know, and to just really clarify that strategy of what customer experiences matter. Because there's so many possible things you can do that if you try and do all of them, particularly if you try and do all of them at once, it's just going to be chaos. I'm a big believer that marketing technology is most successful when you decide one or two of the most important things to focus on and really try and get them done really, really well. you know, and then take another step and then a step after that.
That's great advice. And I guess for a marketer, that's good to hear. You only need to focus on the things that you, it's just a new dimension of your customer strategy, in a way, giving you more tools to actually accomplish what you want in a multi-channel setting, I guess.
Yes, doing a few things well rather than many things poorly. I guess in life, not just in marketing, that remains pretty true.
Well, then kind of trying to transform your organization in this setting, I mean, it's a leadership challenge as well. New competences needed. You have to get your team to buy into new tools or new methods. What would you say are some kind of key success factors of organizations where this is going really well, the leadership part?
Yeah, well, one of the things I really argued for here for a while, maybe argued isn't the right word, advocated, that's a better word, advocated for is the embrace of agile management in marketing. And I don't mean just agile as in, like an adjective like, hey, we should be agile, we should be nimble. That's true, you should be, but very specifically agile as the management methodology that really grew up in the software development world, these agile software development approaches like Scrum and Kanban. I know kind of crazy names. But, this idea of approaching marketing management instead of this long cycle of like a yearly marketing plan that is very rigid and very specific for a 12-month period, to instead look a little bit more, establish a strategy for the year, sort of a high level vision of what marketing needs to accomplish and how, but provide a lot more flexibility to, we've got a distraction from the mascot dog of chiefmartech.com. To given that, very high level strategy of what does marketing want to accomplish for the year, to then take it the way we execute that is using these agile techniques that work on much faster iterations, 2-3 week iterations where marketing is able to break things down into smaller pieces, deploy them into the market faster, learn from them, and be able to adjust as they go. But I find companies that are able to embrace that agile management approach in some sort of way, it is organizationally a much better way for them to be able to deal with all this complexity and all this change.
Well, that's great advice, I guess, now that everyone are done with their 2017 marketing plans. Scrap those and go into an agile mode, right?
Well, think of it as a, it's a big difference between a plan and a framework. A plan implies like, okay, these are very specific things we're going to do. A framework says, okay, this is sort of the scaffolding, by which we're going to organize what we do, but to recognize that, yeah, it will have to adapt. It will have to change because you cannot predict what's going to be happening in your market or in marketing in general within the next 6 to 12 months.
All right. So if a marketer would want to learn more about this agile methodology, where would you recommend they turn to?
Ah, wow. This is actually the perfect setup. I wrote a book.
No, it was not planned.
So I wrote a book called Hacking Marketing. It's available on Amazon. And it's actually, the book itself covers a lot of ways in which software and marketing share a lot of similarities today. But about half the book is really dedicated to showing marketers how those agile management techniques from the software world can be adapted really very effectively in the context of marketing.
That's fantastic. And I can recommend that book. So
thank you.
This was not a planned question, but excellent advice. So now looking forward to 2017, then what are some of the kind of interesting things in the MarTech space that you're looking forward to discovering or anything happening in the market? What's your kind of, things you're waiting for to happen in 2017?
Yeah, that's a fun question because, there's so much happening in this space. I think the two biggest trends that I see are certainly the advancement of artificial intelligence technologies starting to be embedded in more and more marketing technology products. You know, AI has been talked about for years, but what has finally happened here is we've reached a tipping point where, thanks to, you know, really cheap, fast, scalable computing and storage power, you know, in the cloud. Now, all of a sudden, these AI algorithms are now accessible to almost anyone, you know. And so we're starting to see a lot of adaptation of that in marketing. And I think it's going to be really interesting over 2017 to see just how dramatically that could change what we think of as marketing technology, how it works. The other area that I find really fascinating, and again, this is another one of these buzzwords that for a long time had not been very real, but all of a sudden is becoming quite real, is Internet of Things, which to me more broadly is, I think of as digital everything. This idea that, okay, digital isn't just a website or a mobile app anymore. It might be a chatbot. It might be something like a voice-controlled voice command center. It might be an application on your watch. It might be a virtual reality headset. It might be a connected car or a connected television. I mean, the list goes on and on. A lot of this stuff that was, you know, science fiction not too long ago is now, again, thanks to AI and thanks to, you know, just the cheap availability of computing and storage, it's now becoming very real. And so for marketers, this is going to be so incredibly exciting, because all these new digital touch points become new ways of engaging our customers, our audience. So I think there's going to be just an incredible amount of innovation around that. Really looking forward to it.
So as a marketer, if I have some leeway in my budget for next year, what AI little, you know, proof of concept or pilot would, you know, what would you recommend? What should I run?
You know, I don't know if individual marketers will have to explicitly think about making an AI investment so much as I think just a lot of the tools that you use, you know, in marketing automation, in website personalization, in content marketing, content recommendation, in analytics, you know, all these sorts of tool sets that up until now have had either very fixed algorithms or they've required a lot of manual effort, right? Like if you run a marketing automation campaign as a marketer, generally you are manually configuring all those different rules for all those different segments. I think what you're going to see is a lot of those vendors are going to be incorporating more and more AI features into their software that will let you turn over to the machine more of the responsibility for identifying customer segments, for optimizing the rules of engagement with them. So hopefully as a marketer, you won't have to explicitly build your own AI software, but hopefully you will find a lot of it in your favorite tools and make your life better.
Fantastic. I'm looking forward to see that happen in the marketing technology space next year then.
Me too.
it's an exciting time we're living in, I'm very happy to hear all of your thoughts on this. We're going to hear more of them at the event on the 2nd of February. So looking forward to that. All of you interested in reading up on Scott's thoughts in the area of marketing technology can visit chiefmartech.com and also read the book, Hacking Marketing.
Thank you.
And we'll see each other again in February.
I'm looking forward to it, Emma. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Bye.